Hey y'all, it's your girl TT once again. I am back at it again with another makeup tutorial. This is gonna be on a rainbow eyeshadow I did in honor of Pride Month. And I'm just starting off with my KARITY Mattes palette. This is my favorite palette for matte, vivid colors. I started off with this purple shade. I am just packing it on and blending it out just above my crease, and then you can see that I take a little bit more and pack it underneath in the outer corner of my eyelid, and I just go back and forth from packing and blending, basically with this color and all of the colors of the rainbow. Starting off with a lighter blue from the KARITY palette, I am focusing this underneath my eyebrow arch, and underneath this shade, I will take the darker blue from the KARITY palette and pack it on, and I'll just go back and forth from packing with the shade Enchant and blending with the shade Feign, and I just go back and forth with the two shades and the two brushes. Because I was using a dark blue and a light blue, I thought it only seemed fair to use a dark purple underneath the light purple, so I'm using Ego from the KARITY palette, and again, blending with the light purple, packing with the dark purple, and just going back and forth with that. Before going in with more purple, I wanted to soften up the perimeter of the eyeshadow, like right underneath my eyebrows. So I'm taking a matte white eyeshadow before dipping into more color. The BH Cosmetics Take Me Back to Brazil palette doesn't have labels or names for their eyeshadows on the palette, so I'm trying my best to show you guys what colors I'm using from that palette throughout the video. I'm taking the light green that's found in that palette and blending it above my crease towards my inner corner. I'm softening up the eyeshadow on top again with the white matte from the KARITY palette. Now I'm going in with Wicked from the KARITY palette, and I'm packing that on the inner corner right underneath the light green. And again, I'm gonna go back and forth with the light green and the dark green several times until it's blended the way I want to see it. Going back in with the blue shades just to give it a little bit more depth and pigment. Same thing with the purple as the blue. I wanted it to be more in depth, I wanted it to be more pigmented, and I just wanted it to overall be more blended. Softening and blending it overall again with the white matte color. Now starting on the other eye, I'm going to be beginning with yellow. So this yellow from the BH Cosmetics palette was kind of just focused on the inner corner above the crease. Below that yellow, I'm using the matte palette again, the shade Tweety. Right underneath that pale yellow, I'm using the more vibrant yellow packing and blending, packing and blending. And next, orange from the BH Cosmetics palette. And I'm focusing this orange from this palette above the crease. Now using a darker orange from the KARITY matte palette in the shade Vegas. I'm using this right under the pale orange underneath the crease. And I'm going to be doing the same technique, such a shocker, pack and blend, pack and blend. I'm extending the same orange from the BH Cosmetics palette towards the outer corner of the eyeshadow.
This big ass vanity that we spent hella money and time on putting together, and I always choose to do my makeup in the front room on this chair.
In that chair
or that chair. It's always this chair or that chair. If it's before school, I might do it at the kitchen table.
Okay, now back to business. I'm using Not Safe for Work, the red from the KARITY palette, right underneath the orange. And I'm going to pack with this color. Before I get crazy with the blending, I want to go back to my BH Cosmetics palette and use the sort of maroony, more darker red in that same area just to give more depth and more pigmentation. And now that we're done packing the dark colors on, we're going to start blending. I use a little bit of the orange and a little bit of the yellow from the BH Cosmetics palette. Taking more orange wherever it's needed, wherever I need more pigments of orange to come out. I'm gonna go over all the colors that need more pigmentation. So that's gonna be the red, the orange, and the yellow. And then I'll also touch up the other eye. So I'm just packing the corresponding color and blending it with a lighter color. Now that everything's blended the way I like, I'm going to soften up the perimeter with the matte white. I'm going to take the shimmery white from the BH Cosmetics palette and use that to highlight the inner corners and just add a little bit of pizzazz to the colors that are in the inner corner. I finished my base makeup off camera. I'm just brushing off my loose powder and just dabbing it in underneath my eyes. And I'm going to go back into the eyeshadow and just flare it out underneath my waterline. Now to place almost like a line of gems underneath my bottom lash line, I'm going to be using an eyelash glue that has a stick and brush applicator, and I just use that to dot glue where I want the gem to be placed, and then I use my tweezers to place the gems exactly on top of the eyelash glue. For those of you who are not familiar with how to use false eyelashes, this isn't a very in-depth sneak peek, but I can provide something like that in the future. I'm just showing you how I cut my lashes, how I brush through them and curl them so they look better when I apply them. I show you how much glue I like to apply, and it's really just a thin strip of glue. You don't want to go crazy with the glue because I like my glue to get tacky fast. After applying the glue, I take the inner corner and the outer corner of the lash and wiggle it back and forth so that the lash band of the falsies have a little bit more of a curvature to it. And I set it aside for like 20 or 30 seconds so the glue can get tacky. And in this time, I like to apply my mascara to my natural lashes. Alright, now this next part is in real time. I want you guys to see how I take my tweezers and start by applying the middle of the eyelashes to the middle of my eyelid and make sure that's as close to my eyelash band line or like my waterline as close as possible. And then I start with the inner corner, and then when that's secure, I tug the outer part of the eyelash to the outer part of my eyelid. Once it feels a little secure, I will push my natural lashes together with the false lashes and just squeeze them together and push them towards my eyelid. It's super hard for me to explain to you guys like how I do these things because I've been doing them for so long now that it's just like muscle memory. But if you would like me to do like a slow down, in-depth full tutorial on how to apply false lashes. I will definitely be happy to do that when I announce all the lashes from my personal lash brand. So just comment down below if you would like a full in-depth tutorial on how to apply false lashes. Anyways, before moving on to the next part of my makeup routine, I always like to push around my eyelashes just to confirm that they're super secure and they are placed exactly where I want them to be. Alright, I'm done lip syncing, I'm done embarrassing myself, it's time to get back to business. And I'm going in with my favorite highlighter. This is just like a pinky, super, super pigmented highlighter. It just looks wet and it's just glistening and I just love it. If you guys couldn't tell, I have lately been applying the highlight up on my like cheekbone area with a small dense brush and then blending out with a super fluffy brush.
You see this highlight? You see this highlight? You see it? You peep that? Are you blind?
So on days that I go super crazy with the eyeshadow, I just kind of have to touch up the under part of my brow, and because I was like continuously going in with that matte white eyeshadow, I really needed to fill in my brows with some more eyebrow powder. And that's the completed rainbow eyeshadow tutorial, guys. I'm throwing in some clips from Snapchat that are just me with the full face on. I am so happy with the way that this turned out. I'm so happy that I took the time to really blend out my eyeshadows. And I'm so happy that you guys stayed to watch this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll catch you guys next time. Bye!